Welcome back to United Tradesman Academy. There have been several people requesting a video of my thought process of how do I troubleshoot? Because in the videos, it doesn't take me no more than 30 minutes or I would say 10 minutes to diagnose, but maybe 30 minutes to repair. So I'm going to be showing you in this video my thought process when I'm going through the house, when I'm talking to and what I'm thinking about, what I'm looking for in the house that's going to give me signals of what I need to go to next. Let's start off with who. When someone calls you, they're going to be giving you information. Now, what you do with that information is going to be key to solving the problem. They may think you're Superman after you do that so fast. Okay, so who I talk to? Miss Mary. Hi, Miss Mary. How can I help you? Oh, my circuit breaker keeps tripping. Okay. So now let's move on to number two. What caused the circuit breaker to trip? Did you notice anything, Miss Mary, in the house? Did you plug your TV in? Did you plug your hairdryer in? Did you turn on your air conditioning unit? Miss Mary, when? What time of day was this? Was it in the morning? Was it in the afternoon? Or was it at night? In the morning could mimic someone blow drying their hair. They plug it in to the outlet, and when they plug it in, it trips the breaker because the high amps. Or midday could resemble a cold day or a hot day when the furnace or the compressor on the AC unit outside is operating at its maximum and it's tripping that breaker. Where? Miss Mary, was it in your bathroom, or was it in your kitchen, or was it on the outlet outside when you were plugging in your Christmas lights? So these will allow me to properly diagnose before I even get to the job, because once I get a inclination of where the issue is, what the issue is, then when I get to the house, I already have in my mind where the issue could be. Whether it's going to be in the bedroom, whether the problem is going to be at the circuit breaker. Okay, I'm going to show two examples of how to diagnose if it's a circuit breaker issue or if it's an issue down the line, down on the circuit. So for demonstration purposes, I have two circuit breakers here. So the first method, how to diagnose a bad circuit breaker. You want to shut the power off to do this. So what you want to do is, we'll just, for example, just say that this is the bad breaker, the one that's in the trip position. And this is a good breaker, the one right underneath it. It's still working. So what you want to do, you want to remove the wire that's on this breaker, that black wire, remove it temporarily. Then you want to remove the wire out of the breaker that's good, the one that's directly below it. You want to put a wire cap on the one that you took out of the good breaker. Put a wire cap on that one. The wire that you took off of this breaker, put it in the known good breaker. So what we just established, we're going to establish if this, we're going to establish if the breaker is the issue or if it's the issue down the line. Now, go back and turn your power back on. Turn that breaker on. If that breaker stays on with the wire you took out of here and it's currently on here, if it stays on, that means you have a bad breaker. Okay, if that breaker trips, now that confirms to me that I have an issue down the line in the house somewhere. Okay, the last example we're going to use, a space heater. Miss Mary, what did you plug in? Oh, I plugged in a space heater. Okay, Miss Mary, where did you plug it in? I plugged it in my bedroom next to my recliner. I was going to sit back and watch some TV. And when I plugged it in, that's when the breaker tripped. Okay, Miss Mary. So now, did the space heater cause the circuit breaker to trip? Or did the outlet cause the space heater to trip? So now, there's two ways we can look at this. The first way is a space heater, by the National Electrical Code, has to be on its own 20-amp circuit. It cannot be plugged in with a general appliance circuit, meaning that the outlets that are tied together in the wall and are all on this 120-amp circuit, you have to have a dedicated circuit for a space heater because of the amps that the space heater is going to pull when you plug it in and you turn it on. So, space heater is the number one fire starter in the winter. So, the next reason that space heater will burn up that outlet, it'll melt the outlet because of the amps that's being pulled in conjunction with a TV that's plugged up over here, a clock, and a phone charger. That's too much for that one circuit. So that will cause this breaker to trip constantly. Now, if this outlet melts, it's gonna cause a circuit breaker to trip. When that outlet melts, it will begin to, the hot and the neutral wire that's plugged in on the back of that, it would allow those two wires to start touching, or it will allow that black wire to start touching the ground wire, which will cause the circuit breaker to trip. Hey guys, look, if you watch this video so far and you think this video is cool, it's good information in it, why not subscribe? Just hit that subscribe button and also too, hit that notification bell so when I do post more videos like this and things you may want to see, you'll get notified. One thing I have noticed that people have been saying that, man, we have you posted videos, we haven't seen any. Well, one thing you have to do is turn your notification bell on, hit that notification bell, and hit the like button. So if you hit the like button, it really helps the channel grow because YouTube, they recommend this video to more people. They need the information just like you. Thank you. Hey guys, sorry I got to end the video here. There's so much more that I could cover on a topic of how to properly diagnose a circuit breaker tripping. So look, email me at unitedtradesmanacademy@gmail.com if you all need more information on how to troubleshoot, how to price your jobs, or even how to start your contracting business, electrical contracting business. I do ask for a small fee in return for the information I'm giving. So if any of you all need that, email me and we can go from there. For you all who stayed to the end of the video, if you find this video informational, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. I have a lot more great content that's going to be coming for aspiring electricians or for electricians who's been doing this for a very long time now. So we'll see you next time back at United Tradesman Academy.